Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. We are under exposition of Hebrew 2:13-18. And again I will put my trust in him, Christ Jesus, and again behold, I and the children which God hath given me, children mean the sons of man, which Jesus took as a laborer, and trained them to become workers or the sons of God with capital S. Christ Jesus was entrusted 11 handpicked brethren, and he took them to perfection. Judah Iscariot was not picked, but God himself picked by Christ Jesus, that he knows the three letters, three R's. So he can keep an account for Christ Jesus. That's why he was holding the money purse and betrayed him, because he loved more mammon than God. For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh means, remember when Christ Jesus took the bread, he told them, take this is my flesh. Flesh means my outward appearance, like we have a flesh which is sometimes brown, black, or yellow colored, whatever color we are. Sometimes we are feel arrogant, or we have egoistic of our flesh. And this is called, St. Paul is said, seed being praised by putting on the mental peace and praising him. He says, no good to praise the seed, that means that you are a white or a brown or black, but put it into soil so that this disappears. That means ego of the flesh is mixed with soil. As a person, when he dies, all his ego dies with him. So this is called the death in Adam. And you rise up in the living in life in Christ Jesus, the plant which bears fruit. Seed cannot multiply, seed can't bear the fruit, so only when it becomes a plant. So that is also the parable of the sower. So congregation, the flesh is the congregation or the body of Jesus, and blood is of Christ, the gospel truth. He also himself likewise took part of the same Eucharist of sacrifice, and not of the remembrance, as these antichrists are taking Eucharist of sacrifice almost every day. That means mocking Christ Jesus more than they mocked John the Baptist, whose baptism they may take two or three times, for when they were children, then this and that. But this one is mocked too much, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death. Death means when you put a plant in the soil, when you die, kill your ego, then only you get the plant coming out of the seed. Then the death seed, string of the death, is killed forever. That is the devil. Sorry, this is the end of the verse. That means in Adam we are born and die. In God we are new creature, which is eternal plant, which is never born, never die. And deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage of the rabbis and temple priests. And they were putting millstones around the people of ritual and keeping them bound up. So Christ Jesus came and delivered us of that bondage through the word of God, or the gospel truth, that is heard and cannot be written down in ink on paper, as St. Paul has stressed. So unless you have ears to hear his word, then you cannot understand gospel. So what you understand is what is written, which is letters, which are useless unless you have the spirit to understand them. For verily he took not on him the nature of angels. Nature of angels mean the sons of men who are perfect in moral laws. Moral laws mean performing all the rituals as the Jewish people do. An ideal married life, and also an ideal married life, how you look after the children and all family, is of angelic. But he took on him the seed of Abraham. Now he was born in the line of Abraham, but he was not the seed of Abraham or of David, because these people had become Jews of the flesh, which was mean sons of Satan. So he himself was the second anointed Adam, and not of the seed of Abraham. He picked the laborers, the seed of Abraham, as John the Baptist baptized men in the name of Abraham. Wherefore, in all things it behoved him to be made like unto his brethren, that he might be a merciful and faithful high royal priest in the things pertaining to God. So Christ Jesus was the royal high priest of God, and he was anointed high priest to make reconciliation for the blasphemers, where we commit blasphemy. You know, we have something in our heart and we say something different from our mouth. So in Christ Jesus, when you hear the word of God, you understand it, then you repent, and then you reconcile through gospel. So blasphemies that originate from your hearts and not the sins, as written in the Bible. The sins, the basis of the sins, which lies in the moral laws of Moses of the people, and transgression against the moral law is sin, and why the blasphemy originates from your heart, or hypocrisy originates from your heart. So in Christ Jesus, it is the blasphemy that counts and not the sins. Sins count in the name of John the Baptist, and Saint Peter was given the royal kingdom. Saint Peter was given the kingdom of heaven, which was of the regime of the John the Baptist. So Saint Peter sat in the seat of John the Baptist, but he himself did not baptize anyone, but the bishops did, because the apostles are twin brethren of Christ Jesus. So what Christ Jesus was doing, the same they did. None of the apostles baptized anyone in water, but the bishops of the churches they did, which were sitting in the name of Prophet Elijah or John the Baptist. For in that he himself has suffered, being tempted, he is able to succor them that are tempted. So Christ Jesus took a normal human birth. He was sinless, but he took the sinful form of human to preach us gospel. That is what John said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word became flesh in the name of Jesus. And the Word was inside his heart, not the physical body, and Christ was in his heart. So unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot preach gospel. There are two Christs. One is as the spirit of man, which is common sense. When you exercise common sense, then you have Christ with small c in your heart, because Holy Spirit is common sense with small s. When you have the very Spirit of God with capital S, then you are representing God, then you possess the extraordinary sense, and then you are a Christ with capital C, the twin brother of Christ Jesus. Saint Paul was one of them.